Once there was a man, and he fell in love with a mermaid. He left his home, he left his brother, and he left his business to live happily ever after. But after a while, he sat on a rock.
There's an ocean of love beyond the shore, beneath the wind, beneath the waves, where we can dream our days away and swim with the fishes to the coral caves. Tides may swirl around us, the ships may pass above, but we won't notice them. We're down deep in our ocean of love.
Old razor really gets dull. Now I know why Bluebeard had whiskers.
I won!
You're terrific!
I can't believe you found this.
What do you want to do today?
I'm waiting to see if the sand crab comes back up.
Right. I think maybe I'll teach Spot some new tricks. He's coming along great. Where do you see?
Here, boy. Attaboy. That's it. Come on. Up. 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 Good boy. Up. Up now. Stay. 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 Watch this. Now ready? Fetch! Go on, boy. Go on.
Yep. 2 or 3 days. We'll have that stick back here.
You're terrific.
You know, to be honest, I miss real dogs.
You miss a lot of things, don't you?
Oh, no. I mean, you know, what's back there to miss in my old life? Bauer produce and my brother Freddy. Traffic jams. I remember one time I was trying to get to Yankee Stadium. I never made it. But I did find this one stand that sold the best potato knish I'd ever had. And wax lips. They sold wax lips. They're my favorite. You could chew them all day. Just wear them and look like Mick Jagger.
Come with me. Look! What do you see?
I see us.
You're beautiful. I'm me. We're both green. You know, I'd make a gorgeous frog.
Watch.
It's New York. Madison, have you been holding out on me?
No. I used to be able to do this before I came to your world. And then I couldn't. Till now.
How do you do it?
I don't know. It's like, remember when I learned real quick from watching Tiv?
Tiv? Oh, TV, yeah.
TV. Isn't this great?
Yeah, it's like cable for mermaids. Do you get Pee-wee Herman? Freddy.
My check bounced again, man. What are we getting paid, man, huh?
Freddy! I see you hiding there, Freddy!
The guys may not come back tomorrow if they don't get their wages now.
Wages? Is that all they're worried about? Is this going to consume their lives? Are they going to become wage slaves?
No.
Well, do you want to be a wage slave, Jerry?
No.
Well, then thank heavens you're working for a man like me.
Look, this is just a small clerical error. Huh? I'm going to talk to the bank. I'll let you in on a little something. Tomorrow, Carl Hooten is coming here.
Carl Hooten, the owner of Family Foods? Yeah.
Biggest chain of supermarkets in New York, and we are going to close a deal to supply produce to all of his stores. We're going to be rolling in dough, huh? So listen, tell all the guys not to worry. And here, take that to your truck. You know, bring some food home to the wife.
Yeah, my wife's allergic to grapes. She gets a real bad rash.
Hey, well, here. Buy her some white.
Oh, thanks, Freddy.
Hey. Ooh. Nice jacket. Jerry will be telling you all about everything at quitting time. That'll be all, men. That'll be all.
Rush shot. Pay fixed.
I told you, we're not going to get anywhere with him.
Alan, I do wish you were here. So I could punch you right in the boogers for leaving.
Would you like to speak to him?
Freddy, have you really got a deal with Carl Hooten or what?
No. I had to beg him just to come here. This whole operation is run on the cuff. I owe everybody. If I don't get this deal tomorrow, Bauer Produce is history. I'm losing it.
I am losing it!
Alan, I didn't mean to upset you. I thought you'd enjoy seeing your brother. You really do miss your old life, don't you?
No, well, Madison, I know I can't go back. It's just Bauer Produce was my father's business and his father's before that. I just wish there was something I could do.
We can go back. As long as I can soak my legs in salt water at the full moon and as long as we're together.
Really? Let's go.
But it's just till we get the business on its feet.
Okay, if it's important to you.
So many times, life works me over. It knocks me out on my feet.
When things get rough, you are the shoulder I lean on when I feel weak. No matter what the odds are, we can face it. Love conquers all.
I'm giving you the best deal I can, Mr. Hooten. My ex-wives find out about this deal, they're gonna haul me off to court.
You're divorced? I didn't know. We're talking partnership here. I always figured a man that can't manage his marriage can't manage business better.
Well, I'm great at marriage. I get married all the time.
Let me tell you about Carl Hooton. I was born poor. I worked myself into being one of the most respected businessmen in New York City. I am living the American dream. I'm in high society, and I like that. But most importantly, my wife likes that. Number one, I'm not going to do anything to hurt my reputation. Shoot, I don't even know if this operation can handle my business. But it is one of the few that's not owned by the guys with broken noses. I heard it was a family business run by two brothers. That looks good. Looks important to me. Family's important to me. Gives you responsibility. Makes you work hard. Where is your brother?
First, let me tell you something about Freddie Bauer. 30 years ago, a child was torn, screaming and kicking in a world he didn't ask for. He never wanted it.
The French were taking their licks at a little town called Bien Bien Phu, and Heartbreak Hotel topped the charts.
Yo, Jerry.
In grammar school, I was a smallish child. And the kids constantly played keep away with my hat.
For goodness sakes, Bauer, what does this have to do with the price of tea in China?
Ready. Sorry I'm late. Mr. Hooton, I'm Alan Bauer. I was delayed a little in getting back from a tropical vacation with my wife. Freddie, close your mouth. You're leaking air from your brain.
Pleasure to meet you. Family comes first, huh?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Alan's, the white Bill Cosby. Has a little house in the suburbs, picket fence.
Mr. Hooton, I don't want to pressure you into making a decision today, but I do want you to know that we will give you a fair price and we'll move out your produce as fast as we can.
Well, I don't know what to make of your brother, but that's the most sensible thing that I've heard all morning long. I'm going to give you a shot. 1 month trial basis.
Thanks.
Now, I'd like to get the wives together, Bauer. I'm taking a big chance with you boys, and I want to be sure you're rock solid. And my Fern, well, she's a great judge of persons.
He'd love that. You'd love that.
Good. I'll have the office get the address, and me and Fern will come a-calling.
Great. Fine.
I always say, you show me a man's home, and I'll show you who a man is.
You got it.
Bye. Bye. Oh, Freddy.
Little brother, it's really you. What are you doing leaving and scaring me like that?
What are you pushing me like that? You're the one who ruined the business.
Don't push your big brother.
Don't push me. You push me first. Yeah. Oh, really me, Freddy.
I thought I'd never see you again.
Oh, good to see. What is this? You bought new office furniture?
So, how's Madison?
Oh, Madison, I almost forgot.
Madison. Whew. How are you?
Thirsty. Can I have a drink?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you. It needs more salt.
Good morning. Oh, Alan, you're back.
I heard about your death. I'm so glad you're feeling better.
Thank you. She's still on tilt from being hit by the lightning?
Yeah. I kind of like her this way.
What's this about a little house in the suburbs? My apartment is in the city.
Well, I sold your apartment.
Why?
For money. Hey, what are you wearing this shirt for? Jerry's shirt, you look like a slob.
Forget about my shirt. What about my apartment?
Hey, don't worry about it, huh? I've got it under control. Come on.
Madison, come on.
Yeah, I sold your apartment and took the money and bought a house in Queens as an investment.
What?
Yo, can I get my clothes back now?
Sure.
Is this beautiful, huh? A real family neighborhood.
This is it.
Not bad, huh?
It's got a pool and everything.
This is your investment?
Our first house. Where's the pool? Is it saltwater?
Oh, let's find out.
Now hold it. An old custom.
Well, it's in move-in condition. Look at that fireplace. Let's check out the rest of the house, huh?
I got it dirt cheap.
Of course. It's the going price of dirt.
Hey, wait till you see the kitchen, huh? I hear it's a real selling point.
You hear? You haven't seen this thing yet?
Well, I kind of bought it sight unseen from a real estate agent named Buffy. But you know, a few chintz curtains and this place will be beautiful. Call me when you get it fixed up.
Alan, look! Oh. It looks just like our waterfall. Plastic. Fresh water. I was hoping for...
Maybe, honey. I don't want to have to put you through this if it's going to be too hard for you.
You could add salt.
Yeah. And you know, maybe we could be the all-American couple.
We'd better be. That's what Carl's looking for.
And what could be more American than a young couple in debt with their first fixer-upper?
We'll make the deal stick. We'll get Bauer Produce back on his feet again. No problem.
I haven't seen you like this in a long time.
Well, you gotta have a challenge. You gotta have something to do.
It makes you happy?
Yes.
Then it makes me happy, and I do love it.
Remember, don't let anybody find out about, you know, keep up a good front.
No problem. What does good front mean?
Hello! I rang the doorbell and it fell off. So I came around back. Hello. I'm Lois Needler, your next-door neighbor. Am I interrupting anything?
Yes, we were kissing.
Hello, Mrs. Needler. I'm Alan Bauer.
Oh.
And this is my wife, Madison.
Yes. Well, I'll be brief. I am the president of the Better Neighborhood Society. This is my card.
Oh, I can tell it has your name on it.
We would like you to join us. Our job is to keep our neighborhood secure and to, well, prevent what the last people did to this place. Believe me, we took care of them. In fact, we'd like to know what plans you have for this eyesore.
We have many plans.
Oh. Yes, we're going to put salt in the pool.
Oh.
And I'm hoping for a lot more kissing.
Mrs. Needler, can I give you a call when we're more settled in?
Oh, yes. And if you'd like, I could keep an eye on the place for you.
An eye? I don't think I'd like that at all.
Yes, well, I'll keep an eye on it just the same.
Thank you, Mrs. Needler.
Just whistle while you work. And cheerfully together we can tidy up the place. So I'm a merry tune. It won't take long when there's a song to help you set the pace. And as you sweep the room, imagine that the broom is someone that you love, and soon you'll find you dancing to the tune. Thank you.
clothes.
Smells great, huh?
Breakfast is the most important meal of the day.
And only you can prevent forest fires.
Oh, I love it when we talk television. Now you just drink your coffee, and I'll get your cereal. Oh, did I make it wrong?
It's great. I just, I'm a little excited about closing this deal with Carl today. I'll just, chew a cup of coffee when I get to the office.
I guess I'm not very much help in the kitchen.
No, honey, you're great. These things take time. And you're terrific for trying. I better go.
I love you.
Alan, is this what being married is like? You go off and I stay at home. I don't like it. But I want to do the right things.
You're gonna be just great. I'll call you from the office.
I just love this thing. Honey bun, you get a chance, you go by and check that Bauer girl out. Here's her address. I love you, buddy.
I was swimming.
Darling, if I look like you, I would never apologize for anything. I decided to drop by informally. Hope you don't mind. I'm Fern Hooten.
I don't mind if you're Fern Hooten, do you?
No, what I mean is, I hate to stand on ceremony.
Thought it was called a patio. If it bothers you, we can go inside.
So? How's the book look?
It's terrible, terrible. You got rocket ships in the columns here? You're playing hangman in the corner?
Hey,
I put every cent back into the business. Expanded. Yeah, you bought some office furniture. We got a sauna in the back here. We got a Swedish masseuse on 24-hour call.
Executive perks. Hey, we have a large executive core here. We have one executive. You.
I'm large.
All right, all right. I let things get a little out of hand, but you didn't help by disappearing.
I know, I know. I'm sorry. I'll figure this out. Mrs. Stimler? The phone?
What?
Phone is ringing.
It's not my fault. The phones ring all the time.
She's right.
Hello, Bauer Produce.
Hello, Carl.
Yeah, Sonny, I know this is short notice, but I arranged for an invitation for you and your brother to a black tie affair tonight. Yeah, it's out on Long Island, out close to you. Alan, I want to meet your wife. And bring your checkbook, son. This is a fundraiser.
Great.
Great? He asked us to bring our checkbook.
We got plenty of checks. As long as he doesn't cash them.
So, Carl wanted us to get to know each other. Where you come from, sugar?
Over there. That was me by the pool.
I mean, originally.
Well, sort of east of here. The ocean.
Really? The Hamptons? Ooh la la!
I grew up near Richmond, Virginia. Closest thing I ever got to the ocean was dating guys from the Navy base in Norfolk.
Say, honey, would you happen to have some juice or something?
Is frozen orange juice okay?
Fine.
Well, I just wanted to get a feel for you folks, Dumplin', and I've done that. Gotta go. I'm getting my body wrapped.
Are you giving it to someone?
I love your sense of humor. Darling, I had my doubts, but you are a kick. I'll let myself out. It's been an experience.
This work. I'll just cut inventory.
I love you, Alan.
I love you, honey.
Why, thank you, Mr. Bauer. And I love you, too.
Can you see me?
You're inside the kitchen sink.
I'm in the kitchen sink. Do me a favor, don't run the garbage disposal while we're talking. Now look, you can't do this.
Why?
Well, it's not human. What if somebody saw?
But it's part of me.
There's some things that you're gonna have to change.
Okay. I miss you.
I miss you too, honey. I'll be home soon. Carl invited us to dinner tonight. I love you.
Alan, are you all right?
Oh, I'm fine. I just hope nothing goes wrong. Wish you told me earlier that Fern had come by.
Well, I called you, but you seemed upset and I forgot. But don't worry, because tonight I am going to be so human that Carl will think we're just like any other married couple. Do you smell fish?
Oh, great, an aquarium.
Why do humans keep other animals in here?
Well, it's hard to explain. We love the ocean. but not everyone can see the creatures down there. So we bring some of them up here to admire.
Oh, I see. It's nice. But what if they don't want to stay?
Well, Bowers like flowers. You gotta have them fresh, and that's what we do.
That's what we have to have.
Oh, Alan and Madison.
Glad to see you at the function, son.
More than happy to be here.
And Madison. Oh, my goodness. Fern said you were pretty, but I had no idea that you were this pretty.
Why, keep your flaps down, Carl. Hi.
Pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Hooten.
Fern, sugar. Fern just hates standing on patios.
Why don't we just go over here for a sec? Boy, you sure do have a lot of fish here.
Oh, got crawdads, all kind of crustaceans.
Say, how did you get on the aquariums board anyhow?
Well, I just bought myself on. I tried to get on the board of Lincoln Center, but it didn't fill. So I gave this outfit $1 million for research, and boom, all of a sudden I'm hobnobbing with a hoi polloi.
Well, Carl, this place is fantastic. I've never seen anything like it.
Hold a lot of hay, wouldn't it, son, huh?
Well, yeah, it would.
Tell me, little lady, do you like fish?
Oh, yes, except for sailfish. I've never seen a more stuck-up fish. You can't talk to one. Goodness knows I've tried. Once I was foraging for kelp, one comes right.
How large a contribution would the aquarium appreciate anyway?
We'll be back right after a second.
Whoop. Last check.
Did I do something wrong?
No. I just think you're trying too hard. Why don't you stay right here, and I'll get us some dinner.
Okay.
Salty seems to like you, but not that I can blame him. I mean, you are quite lovely. Permit me to introduce myself. I'm Dr. Otto Bennis. May I offer you my arm?
I have my own, thank you.
Oh, yeah. I work with Salty. I've just received a grant from the aquarium, a most generous grant, to begin the most important and lucrative research of my career.
Really? What kind of research?
Well, suffice it to say that I'm going to make Salty famous. The board thinks that I'm going to be using electrodes and computers to enable mankind to see how a dolphin experiences the world, but I'm going to do much, much more than that. I've got big plans.
My Alan has big thumbs.
Is that a fact? Listen, would you like to see the top of the tank? My laboratory's up there.
Madison? Oh, there you are. Let's go to dinner. Excuse me.
Oh, Salty, you do have talent. And I'm gonna take it. What are you touching?
I don't know.
Here, put this on. It's a stethoscope. Never touch anything unless I tell you.
You got that?
Got it.
I'm telling you. Good boy. You know, I could ruin your career before it's even started. Or I could make you quite famous.
Like Sean Penn?
I suppose.
But I don't want to hit anybody.
Just turn on the light. This is a model of a dolphin's brain. Somewhere in there is a lobe that allows the dolphin to send detailed pictures to one another, brain to brain. Now, what if man were able to do that?
That would mean the end of cable.
It would mean power, my empty-headed little being. Power. First, I intend to locate that lobe with these tiny little electrodes. Then, Salty, get into the other tank. Then I plan to remove that lobe and implant it in a human brain. Think of it. A quarter of a million dolphin are killed each year to protect tuna catches. They eat tuna. Well, this human could tell the dolphins how to herd the tuna into the nets and eat not a one.
Won't they starve?
Perhaps.
And if you take this lobe out of Salty's brain, now that won't hurt him.
What is a dolphin to you, or you to a dolphin, that you should weep for him?
Ooh, no!
Come in, Madison. Fern? Madison, where are you?
In the kitchen where I belong.
Charles is having a father and kids picnic. I'm going to get the bring the three lights and everything.
Are you okay? I was just watching a show on how to please husbands. It's called Leave It to Beaver, and it's very educational.
Do you mind a personal question?
Not until I know what it is.
How are things going with Alan?
It's fine. He's very excited to be back at work with Freddie. It takes up a lot of his time, but he's happy.
And you're not, are you? Honey, you could use some help in the marriage department. Forget the house. We'll remodel you. I'll make you my personal pet project.
You would do that for me?
Grab your purse and let's go.
But what if Alan calls?
Sit down over there. Lesson number one, equality. You want to go out, you go out, just like him. And I'll tell you something else. You need to find something meaningful in your life.
Well, Alan says that this is meaningful.
Alan can't give you that. See, it's different for women today. When I was a girl, you wanted to grow up and marry a guy just like Daddy. Now you can grow up and be just like Daddy. A doctor, a lawyer. If you want to be a housewife, that's fine, but it's your choice.
Are you what you always wanted to be?
Yes, dear. I'm very rich. Now, come on. This is your life. You can do what you want.
I can? I can't. I will. Can I drive? Oh. You know, I watch a driving show all the time. Where are we going? To the aquarium. It's important. Stop this driving show.
We're not really supposed to be up here.
Salty!
Come
are you doing? Stop them! Hey!
Oh, come a heel!
What are you doing here? How did you get up here?
Let go of her!
Who are you?
My husband is Carl Hooten, and he's a member of the board of directors of this aquarium.
This is Mrs. Hooten, you fool.
I'm sorry.
Of course he's sorry. I thought she was going to fall in. I didn't know. You get back to the lab. Go on now. And you make sure he gets back to the lab. I'm terribly sorry, Mrs. Hooten. Perhaps we could arrange at some other time, convenient to us both, for her to fall in or something of that nature. I'll be going.
You are going to be more work than I thought.
I'm glad we came here. At least you'll get a little exercise up and down the stairs, right?
Okay, honey.
Herb, look. It's that Bauer couple.
Okay, honey.
So Carl invited us to the country club. Freddie thinks that means he wants to make the deal permanent. So I think we really did it. Is there something wrong?
You've just been talking about business the whole night.
Oh, well, things have been going so well. There's been so much to tell. I'm sorry. We'll talk about whatever you want.
Thanks. I went to the aquarium today to talk to Salty the dolphin.
You shouldn't have done that. What if somebody saw you?
Fern told me that it's good to have something important to do. And this is important. He asked me to do something, but I don't know how to tell you.
Just tell me.
What if two people had known each other a long time and something happened that separated them? Like, maybe one thought the other one was dead. What would you do if that happened to us?
I guess I'd try to phone you or send a telegram or something. I don't get the point of all this.
Well, Salty didn't have a chance to tell anybody where he was going or when he'd be back. I think I can help him. I know. Why don't you tell him?
Are you crazy?
Maybe he's shy.
Yes, more water, ma'am?
No, thank you.
Was everything satisfactory?
It was delicious. My husband will pay you when he comes back.
Certainly. Do take your time.
He went under the table and he still hasn't come up.
Look at what he's eating and don't order that.
Boy, you really blew it this time. Madison, your skirt split.
Excuse me. Might I have a wine list, please? Thank you. Good night, Mrs. Needler.
Good night, Mrs. Needler.
remember, we're the all-American couple. Okay? I'll do all the talking. To people, not to dolphins.
Bar! Come over here, son. Welcome to the club.
Thanks.
I can tell you there's not much to it, but there is. Oh,
sure is. I love the smell of money in the afternoon.
They got everything here. I think I'll take Madison while you men talk business.
Good idea.
If there's anything that I can do for you, Miss Bauer, you just let me know, honey.
Oh, Mr. Hooten, that is so sweet of you. Can you get the aquarium to release Salty the dolphin?
You're not a member of one of those animal cults, are you?
You know, he's a feeling creature. He's not a toy for doctors to play with.
So, anybody thirsty? I'm parched.
Yeah. I want one. Get me one!
We'll get you one. Won't we, dear?
He'll get you one.
What were you doing over there?
Nothing. He asked if there was anything he could do for
me. I know that he asked, but that's not what he meant.
Why would he say something that he doesn't mean?
Well, he was being polite. That's the way humans are. I mean, say a friend of mine says, Alan, how are you? And I got, like, a thing in my tooth and my cat died. Well, I'm not going to tell him.
What would you say?
I'd say, fine, thanks. And you?
Why?
Because he's not really asking. And I'm not really answering.
Then why are you talking?
We are being polite. You have got to learn things like being polite.
I don't think I understand people.
Madison, forget about Salty the dolphin. We need to save Bauer Produce. That's why we came back.
You have got to save Bauer Produce. I have to help Salty. And furthermore, I am not June Cleaver. And I think the beef has big teeth. You know what you are? You're a...
This was just a test. In the event of an actual emergency, you would have known it, because you're all intelligent people, and I'm proud to be among you. I salute you. Why? Why is it so important to you?
When we first came back, you said it was good to have something to do, a challenge. Well, you were right. Alan Dolphin's mate for life. And Salty wants his mate to know that he's going to be all right and that he'll be home soon. He doesn't want her to die of a broken heart. I have to find her and tell her.
Can't you just stick your fingers in a glass of water and we can go back and apologize?
It doesn't work if I don't know where she is, or if she's angry or confused.
What about us? What about what we're trying to do here together?
Alan, we can only be together if there are two of us. But if either one of us gives up an important piece of ourselves, the other one's going to be alone, even if we are together.
You're going back there, aren't you?
Yes.
I guess we don't have a hold on one another.
Alan, I will always be your wife. We were married in Neptune's ceremony.
I know we were married, but what does it mean? We're not doing too well together here. Back on the island, I was getting real bored. I didn't tell you because I didn't want you to, didn't want to upset you. I was trying to be nice.
Is that like being polite?
Yes.
Not telling the truth to your mate. Maybe I'll never fit in here.
Yeah. Madison, no, wait! I didn't mean it! I didn't mean it!
Confidential tape number one. I, Dr. Otto Benas, make this tape in order to prove my good intentions. Should anyone question my use of the board's money in the way that it was intended? To control the thoughts of another, I intend to do just that. You horse, you ox, you zebra, you less than senseless thing.
I just thought I'd pick up some atmosphere.
Just put the camera, just... Let us continue. My first subject will be a lower order mammal. Lower than my assistant, although highly intelligent. He is commonly called the dolphin. Phase one. I shall obtain the trust of the animal by submitting him to my will through domination. Making him submit to my will totally. Let Salty into the tank.
Right in the stomach!
Hello, Madison.
Oh. Hi, Freddy.
I'm coming in. No, I know I said that 3 days in a row, but this time I mean it. No, I'm getting dressed, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Gotta get on with the rest of my life. Bye.
Such a jerk.
Alan, I found Salty's mate. You should have seen her face when I told her that her mate was still alive.
I know how she felt.
But that's not even the best part. She's going to have Salty's baby. He's going to be a father and he doesn't even know it. Isn't that romantic?
Yeah.
You know, when I left, I thought that all I had to do was to find her and tell her that he was all right. But now I see that we have to find a way to get them back together. He has to be there at the birth. Maybe Carl can tell the aquarium to let him go.
I don't know. I just got Carl over the country club incident. Maybe they'll let Salty go in plenty of time.
But I have to be sure. Salty is very special to me. He was there at my birth.
Okay. I'll make Carl find out how long they need Salty.
I promise. I love you.
Herb, I just heard something.
Okay, honey.
I think I heard something over at the Bowers.
Okay, honey.
What are you gonna do? Take him in?
Oh, no, you're not getting away.
Alan, no! Alan! Alan! Oh. Oh. Oh.
Herb! Herb! Call 911. He's killing her. He's drowning her.
You got it, honey.
Oh. This way. Oh. There he is. There's the murderer.
Wait a minute. What's going on here?
Ask him where his wife is.
Is something wrong, officer?
Well, she looks pretty warm-blooded to me.
I don't know what the problem is, officer. My wife and I are just going for a little swim.
Look, Mr. Bauer, we're sorry about the bother. Let's go. False alarm.
I know something weird is going on with you people, and I swear I'll find out.
Lady. Mm. Mm.
Otto's gonna do what?
Harvey, something strange is going on here. Look, he is definitely communicating with someone. But who?
I don't know.
All right. We'll just speed up the timetable and go directly to phase two.
The one where we operate on his brain?
I told you, never repeat that out loud. You just don't know who's listening.
Alan.
What? I said, did you hear something?
What?
I said...
Bert! I have to talk to you.
What are you doing here, Madison?
It's about Salty. You've got to make Carl let him go.
Sugar, that's pretty near impossible.
Salty was captured for $1 million research project.
The aquarium can't afford to lose that kind of money. With publicity? I know Carl won't do it.
But you said a woman should do what she believes in.
I'm sorry. I'm late for an appointment.
Madison! I guess I did get you started on this. Any friend of yours is a friend of mine.
Thank you.
Besides, I'll help. What do you have in mind?
Well, I'll need a uniform.
Yet, are we, you deflated rubber duck?
hold the car.
Salty! Come on, swim hard, Salty. I know you can do it. I know it's dangerous. You have to do it. Can't you help any farther, Salty?
Busy little beaver, aren't we? Oh, no. Oh, no, you don't. No. Salty, let go! Deliver this woman to the police and have her arrested.
What's going on?
Oh, Alan, it was so exciting. Fern and I got tossed into the slammer on a 487. Isn't that right, you lousy flatfoots?
Right, Mrs. Bauer.
What's a 487?
Oh, grand theft. They got caught trying to steal a dolphin down at the aquarium.
You were arrested?
Yeah, but Carl sprung us just before they gave us the chair.
Well, that's a relief.
Thanks for the crepes, Mrs. Bauer. They were really delicious, but, we better get back down to precinct now.
Oh, I'll walk you out.
Oh, no, no, no. We can find our way.
All right.
Thanks for coming by, fellas. Next time, bring your families.
Well, and weren't they nice? You know, you should get arrested sometimes. You can meet the nicest people in prison. Do you want a crepe?
Yeah, no. Madison, how could you do this?
Well, I tried to reach you first, but I couldn't get through, so I went to Fern.
I don't know what to say. I'm trying this time. I'm really trying. I stuck my neck out. I made Carl find out how long they're going to keep Salty at the aquarium, just like I promised.
Alan, that's not enough. You don't understand.
No. I don't. Look, now I am going to have to go and find Carl and explain this to him so it doesn't blow the whole deal. Thanks a lot.
Alan... Alan! Alan!
And don't bother Mr. Houghton again.
Thanks. How long's this been here?
Ever since they put it here.
Oh. Alan, we gotta have a talk.
Go ahead. Mrs. Stemmler, if you would excuse us, I'd like to have a private talk with my brother.
Oh, certainly, Mr. Bauer. I'll go find him for you. Would you excuse me, please?
Take it quick, Freddy. I'm very busy. What do you want?
I want to talk about you. What's wrong with you? I heard you slept here last night.
It's not me. It's Madison. She's obsessed with Salty the Dolphin.
Hey, this is the woman that you gave up everything for? Huh? This is the woman who gave up everything she had for you. So she comes up here, she sees there's a little more to life than just swimming around eating fish, and you can't deal with it. I'll tell you, she's growing. You're the one with the problem.
I tried. All right? I tried.
But we are just two incredibly different people. That's
what makes it so much fun when you kiss her.
Oh, come on, Freddy.
Hey, have you forgotten how special she is? Huh? You got a one in a million here, brother. Hey, you got a one in a billion. Look, there are times when you expect her to support you 100% no matter what. Well, you got to show her the same support, even if you don't understand it. She's your wife.
Where do you get this, Ann Landers?
No, that Oompa Wimpy.
Oprah. Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah, whatever.
You watch Oprah Winfrey?
Hey, she's a woman, isn't she? Look, will you just listen to me? I'm serious. Look at me. I never believed in anything other than the fact that one day somehow I am going to get a date with Vanna White. Hey, fish, woman, mermaid, you got somebody to share your life with. Somebody to believe in right in front of you. If you're going to take fruits and vegetables over that, over Madison, then you're the one that's got the problem, buddy.
Hi, honey.
Alan, where were you?
I was at the aquarium.
Aquarium?
Yes. I'll explain. But first, there's something I have to tell you. You've always been there for me. And I haven't always been there for you. And I'm sorry.
You're only human.
Right. And you're not. And that may be the heart of my problem. See, I may not always understand what's important to you. Like this salty business. But if you say it is important, that's enough for me. I'm behind you 100%. You're my wife.
You'll help me get salty?
You bet.
Oh, Alan, thank you. It's more than just the birth now. I was wrong. Dr. Bennis never intended to let Salty go. He wants to cut open his brain. We have to get him right away.
Well, I think I found a way. That's why I spent the day at the aquarium. Tell him that there is a hoist in the lab that goes through a skylight in the ceiling. We'll bring a stretcher into the lab, and then he'll have to get into it. Then we'll just lower him into the truck. Tell him.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on! That foul woman attracted too much attention to us. We'll begin the experiment on Salty tomorrow. We can't wait. Are you absolutely clear on how to prep Salty?
I don't know.
Okay. Looks like we're gonna have to do this tonight. You stay here and get the stretcher into the lab as soon as the aquarium closes tonight. I'm gonna see about getting us some help.
I love you.
Who are you talking to, honey?
No one. Okay, I was trying to call Madison. I got a message from her husband, but I haven't been able to reach them all day.
Now, I told you not to go around those people. They trouble.
I guess you just don't love me anymore.
Now, why do you want to start saying things like that? You know, things like that just tear me up.
I know. Then let me help Madison. I think I know where she is.
That woman has changed you. Come here, Puddin.
I'm getting a headache. A very bad headache. It's gonna last a long time. I'm going for a walk.
All right. All right. Just don't use my name, honey.
Oh, sweetie.
Dean.
That's it. Let's go.
Hey, going out the skylight. Go! Go! Go on! Get ready!
It makes me look like an official fish delivery man. It
makes you look like a nerd.
Hey.
Don't push me.
Don't push me. Don't push me.
Don't push me.
You should put your hat on.
Give me that.
Hey, give... That's my hat.
I don't care.
You can... Give me... That is... I bought those. Okay? Come on. Quit
push me.
That is my hat.
I don't care. It looks stupid.
Well, can I help you, gentlemen?
How you doing? We're here on that delivery.
I'm not expecting any delivery tonight.
We got a rush delivery for Dr. Bennis. We got his baby walrus.
I don't know anything about a walrus.
It's a big furry creature. Looks a little something like this.
Okay. You know where you're going?
To the devil, but I'd like to drop the walrus off first.
Baby walrus? I don't know what you're talking about. Alert the armed patrol. Harvey, fetch my dart gun. Salty's gone.
Look, the skylight's open.
Salty, take it easy.
That'll be quite enough, my dear. Perhaps we should retire you from the dolphin rescue business. Permanently. Very clever. Harvey, wait for me down in the laboratory. Have a seat on the ledge, my dear. Now!
Thank you.
Listen, you just take care of Salty. I have tapes. I'm taking them to the board.
If there's ever anything I can do for you.
Is she here of a job?
Kay.
Where's that dart?
Oh, swell.
Keep it going.
Okay, that's it. Hold it right there. I don't want to have to hurt anyone.
You, get over there next to the guy with the nerd hat on.
I told you in the truck that was a nerd cap.
Oh, well, hey, I know. Hey. It's a dirty cap. Are you
it's
happy?
It's a dirty
happy?
Nerd cap.
You...
Hey,
now, are you happy?
Hey, let go of the fish.
I don't think you want that to happen.
I said, let go of the fish.
Get up there, hurry up.
Whoa, Salty, okay?
I'm Salty, fine. Get in the back with me. Freddy will drive. Okay.
What's he saying?
He's saying you need to go to the washroom.
Tell him he should have gone before we left.
Just keep wetting him down. If he dries out, he'll die.
I am.
Oh, careful.
Freddy? What's going on?
It's Fern. Go to the guardhouse and see if there's a key.
So is Salty.
He needs water badly or he'll die. Can we stop somewhere?
We'd be taking an awful risk. Freddy! What's taking so long?
I had to take the back roads. You want to get caught?
Are you sure this is the way to the shore?
I didn't want to worry him. I think we're lost. Get up here. I don't know where we are.
What?
We're dead lost.
Alan, we've got to hurry. Salty's not going to make it.
Okay, Madison, you come up front with me.
Don't you worry, Madison. We'll look after Salty. Come on, Frank.
Madison, can you sense where the ocean is? Can you tell me?
That way, over there.
How far?
I don't know. I can't tell on land.
It's okay. Get in. Breathing pretty hard.
Done. I guess you'll be going back to you, your island.
I don't understand this big secret about why you have to go. I'm gonna miss you. You're like my baby girl.
Bye, little brother. Bye, Freddy. Bye, Madison.
Bye, big brother.
Bye, Fern.
I'm not going anywhere.
Well, that's okay.
I don't want to go.
What?
You're right, Madison. We have to be honest with each other. I don't want to go back. I will if you need it.
I like it here. I like to learn things. And I would miss Freddie and Fern so much. I want to stay, too.
You sure? It's not going to be easy.
Yes.
Whatever it takes, we'll make it work.
Salty's coming back.
Look!
He's already had the baby.
Family.
A lot of mermaids have babies.
You'll see.